The point of the human exploration of space is to benefit everyone on Earth. My name's Nick Hague, and I'm the commander for NASA's SpaceX Crew-9 mission to the International Space Station. Space is really hard. It's dynamic, it's unpredictable, and we've seen that play out over the last several months. But that's no different than the way it's always been. And so it's phenomenal to be part of a team that you see them respond to that and throw themselves at these new challenges and figure out ways to make it happen. It just makes you really proud to be part of the NASA team. I grew up on a farm out in western Kansas, looking up at the night sky, staring at the stars, dreaming about exploring space. At some point when you're growing up, the childhood dream of going to space transitions to a professional ambition. And for me, that time was at the test pilot school at Edwards Air Force Base. I've been to the space station before. My first launch was not quite successful, and we aborted about 2 minutes into the flight. So what was supposed to be a 200-day mission ended up being a 20-minute mission. I was able to try again 5 months later and complete the job that I was asked to do, which was go to the space station and spend 6 months on board. So I was part of Expeditions 59 and 60. Our mission hasn't changed. It's to get to the space station, conduct research, and come home. How we're going to do that is gonna look a little bit different. This time, we're gonna launch with just two crew. We're gonna have two empty seats for Butch and Sonny so that at the end of our mission, we're going to be able to bring them home. But one of the most exciting and challenging aspects of what lie ahead is how Alex and I are going to integrate into their crew. You know, they've been on the station for several months already, and it's gonna be thrilling to be able to join them and get to work, doing that mission of discovery, conducting science, performing upgrades on the station, figuring out how to live and work, not just in low Earth orbit, but how we're gonna do that when we go to the moon and on to Mars. Safety culture at NASA is so critical. We manage risk every day. Just being able to watch the agency navigate those decisions over the last several months and balance the risk and the safety of the crew and the well-being of the crew and the vehicle and the mission has been phenomenal. What is crystal clear in that entire process is the commitment to making sure that when we launch crews, we're going to bring them home safe.